Amanda, it seems like the conservatives have been scamming the American public politically for so many decades, I've lost count. But now we find out that the scams are a little more direct. It seems that they're kind of taking advantage of fear and anxiety to collect big, big bucks for themselves. Tell us this story. Very good story that you wrote here, conservatives still scamming the base. Very well done. Give us the 10,000 foot on this.
So basically, one of the things that, and I definitely give credit to organizations like Media Matters for really keeping track of this, one of the ongoing problems in the conservative movement is that a lot of their leaders and pundits and politicians are basically running long-term mail order scams on their actual followers. So like you see a Mike Huckabee or Ben Carson or guys like that, they create these big old, and Newt Gingrich is a really bad one for this. They create these email lists of followers and supporters, and they use these lists to just spam them relentlessly with asks like advertisements for BS insurance scam or
cancer cures or well look let me cures, let me ask you this okay scams. So it begins with we have to collect the emails, right? And yeah. That maybe is Mike Huckabee running for president. He collects the email list. Or Newt Gingrich runs for president. He collects the email list. Then they get together with some huckster, some scammer, and says, look, I can cure cancer. And so I want to use your email list for this fake cure of cancer or Alzheimer's disease or whatever it may be. And we want to use what you've collected and go after these conservatives. Now, you also see this with political PACs. I mean, you have a political PAC that is out there saying, you know, if you were really angry about in your article, you talk about if you were angry about, say, maybe Jeb Bush getting into the race in Florida, past governor, now is going to run for president. If you don't like that, send us money and we'll solve the problem. What do they do with money like that? Typically, what's the split with money like that? When some, you know, Tea Party conservative says, oh, I'm going to give this money so I can stop Jeb Bush. What happens next?
You see about 1 to maybe 5% of the money that you donate to these political PACs actually going to candidates. You know, a really good example or bad, depending on how you want to see this, is Sarah Palin. She started the Sarah PAC, and, you know, she just spams all these followers all the time with, like, asks for money, promising them that if they give Sarah Palin money, she will turn around and help elect conservative candidates to office. It seems that most of the money that you give her goes to Sarah Palin.
okay, but your article talked about, you know, if they're spending $205,000, if that's the typical kind of money collected, about 7% of that might actually go to what she says it's going to go to. Is that an accurate number?
Yes, okay. Yeah, that is exactly right. And so, you know, basically it's just a bunch of, and the thing is that's frustrating about this is, like, one of the reasons that conservative politicians and figures get away with this is because, you know, let's be honest here, the right is, like, predominantly older. There are a lot of elderly people that are Republicans and conservatives, and, you know, they're kind of ripe for being attacked in just this way.
Well, they're used to sending $25 to Pat Robertson, aren't they? I mean, Pat Robertson is on the 700 Club, has been kind of getting them ready for this whole thing. Send money and miracles happen. And so the miracles here are kind of political miracles or cancer cure miracles or Alzheimer's disease miracles. And they are particularly gullible, aren't they? I mean, they are kind of really prey to this, aren't they?
Yeah, I mean, it really goes to show that you see that the conservative leaders know that their followers must be gullible, first of all, to follow them. But what you definitely see is kind of this huge machine that stokes a lot of fears and panic, unnecessary fears and panic, in often elderly people, elderly white people that are often not necessarily like that plugged into the world. They watch a lot of Fox News and they start to think the world is going to hell and that we're on the verge of having an apocalypse and race riots and whatnot. And so they sign up for Mike Huckabee's email listserv. And in there, there's a bunch of advertisements for when the apocalypse comes, you need to buy gold or buy
survivalist gear.
And stuff like that. And they're just basically robbing these people blind. And, you know, like on one hand, it's tempting to write it off as like, well, you know, suckers deserve what they have, deserve what's coming to them. But on the flip side, it's like, you know, a lot of these people are, you know, they're paranoid and they're conservative, but they aren't necessarily bad people. You know, a lot of them are people I suspect that we have in our own families, and we should be concerned that they're spending their retirement savings.
Well, okay, but you know what? If you ran this by 10 people who have watched all this develop over the last few decades, and you've seen this hate and this anger and this paranoia, this fear that just seems to absolutely saturate every bit of this kind of elderly conservative mentality, it is very difficult to have much sympathy for this. I mean, look, we both agree on this. Most of this is driven by fear and anxiety, and that's what the Mike Huckabees and the Eric Ericsons and the Newt Gingriches, this is what they capitalize on. But at some point, I guess if I was a Republican, I would be saying it's the market taking care of itself, because that really is their mantra. You know, gee whiz, the weak get gobbled up. Well, in this situation, you've got Republicans who are gobbling up their own people. Now, let's shift over to the political side of it, though. I mean, you've got people who actually run for office knowing they don't have a snowball's chance in hell to ever win. You know, Mike Huckabee, it's almost a caricature of that. I mean, every day it's some kind of ridiculous, outrageous statement that he makes, and he knows it doesn't have any national appeal. There's no way it's going to float nationally. So why does he run? He runs to make money, doesn't he?
Yeah, exactly. And we saw that in 2012, and we're going to see it again in 2016. If you want to know why the Republican primary had so many candidates in it that they had trouble getting them all on stage, this is exactly why.
It's a moneymaker.
It's all about the money. It's all about the Benjamins. Like, they run for president. They use this national platform. All this, basically, it's a way to get free advertising for your email listserv. And to get somebody else to sort of pay for it. You know, you do all this fundraising to run, so you don't have to pay for it out of pocket.
Right. Now, they live on this, too, though. I mean, let's be clear. They can live on this. Not like anybody tells them they can't spend it on anything in particular. Isn't that accurate?
I think, it kind of depends. I mean, on campaign fundraising, there are restrictions on how you can spend that
but
money.
But they're minor. I'm telling you, I've looked at this very minor. It's amazing what these people can actually live on this money. I mean, if you figure they're traveling around and eating and whatever it is. So right now, if we assume that it has become a business, the business of running for president is a money-making business, then all of a sudden, your point is, we're going to see a lot of people on stage, and it's not going to really have much to do with qualifications. I mean, everybody that, looks into Ben Carson's eyes more than 10 seconds knows this guy is going nowhere. Same with Huckabee. Same, we knew that with Sarah Palin. But if it's such a business, why isn't the Republican Party saying, you're killing us? I mean, in a sense, it's killing the Republican Party on a lot of different levels. First of all, it's taking money away from serious candidates, and you've got a clown brigade out there.